Hey y'all, it's Care. As the title suggests, this video is my summer romance reading recommendations video, which is an alliteration if I've ever heard one. First of all, let's go ahead and address the elephant in the room here. Of course, I think you guys should be reading Beach Read by Emily Henry this summer. I think you probably also would enjoy The Unhoneymooners by Christina Lauren. You know what? Go ahead and check out the Brown Sisters series if you haven't already done so. I wanted to go ahead and just like mention some of those books up front because I don't want to continue to run these recommendations into the ground. I want to keep you on your toes a little bit, so I've tried to compile a list of 20 pretty fresh recommendations from me at least, just so you don't get bored throughout the rest of the video. But before we talk about all of the books, I want to go ahead and thank the sponsor of today's video, Ana Luisa. Ana Luisa is an ethical and a sustainable jewelry company whose goal is to enjoy and to celebrate the beauty of the earth without leaving a trace. Their jewelry is simple, but it really is striking, and it's so easy to layer and it's easy to match with literally any outfit. You can click the link in my description box to visit their website and get 10% off your entire order using my discount code CarolineJohnson10. All of their jewelry is carbon neutral, which means that they offset 100% of their carbon emissions, starting with the sourcing of their raw materials all the way to the disposal of their pieces. The prices for the jewelry start at $39.99 and range to higher end pieces, but without a luxury markup. So there really is something for everyone. Something for you, something for your best friend, maybe your dad wants a bracelet. Actually, this video should be going up on Father's Day, so maybe a little too late for your dad, but definitely get something for yourself if you are interested. Ana Luisa has super speedy delivery all across the world, and when they say speedy, they mean speedy. I have ordered from Ana Luisa many a time, and I'm always so pleasantly pleased when the package arrives so soon, like within just a matter of days. Kind of just hinted at it there, but I have been a supporter of Ana Luisa long before this sponsorship opportunity, so I do have quite a few of their pieces in my collection, but for today's video, I have two pieces that I really wanna share and show off with you guys. This first one is called the Eve's Necklace. I selected this piece because navy blue is one of my favorite colors, and I also have a lot of blazers and dress pants that either are navy blue or they have navy as an accent color, so I think that this necklace will match very nicely with my work clothes, but then at the same time, I really love the way that navy brings out the blue in denim as well, so you can dress it up, you can dress it down. I also got these scarlet earrings, and I just love the double hoop. These would be perfect if you want that double hoop look, but you don't have the second ear piercings. I do have them going all the way up my ears, so I just can't wait to add more of their huggy hoops that they have to my collection so I can have a whole Ana Luisa party going on my ears. So again, click the link in my description box to visit their site and get 10% off your entire order with my discount code CarolineJohnson10. And go follow Ana Luisa on Instagram and subscribe to their newsletters to stay in the know about their new releases and their exclusive sales. I'm gonna break the video down into three different sections, and each section will be timestamped. Section one is going to have 10 books that I have read, I have enjoyed, and I want to recommend these books to you guys to read this summer. In section two, I'm gonna talk about 5 books that I am currently reading. I do like to read more than one book at once. So just some summary books that I've been enjoying reading out on my porch, that I've been taking to the pool, that I would take to the beach if I were at the beach, you know what I mean. And then section three, I'm gonna talk about 5 books that are on my radar for this summer and that I have queued up for July and August. So looping back to section one, books that I've read, that I've enjoyed, and that I'm ready to recommend to you guys, let's start with number one, Sweet Hand by NG Peltier. This book is a 2021 release, and it is the first book in the Island Bites series, and I just finished this book. I listened to it on audio, and I had such a fun time. This is an enemies to lovers story that takes place in Trinidad, and it's all about Charisse, who is a little island baker, and also like has a heavy social media presence because she is a baker. And then Kieran, he works in the music industry. These two have a past of not getting along at all, but here recently they've been thrown together again because Charisse's sister is getting married and she is the maid of honor, and then Kieran's best friend is getting married, he's the best man, so a lot of their duties overlap for the wedding and they're thrown together and have to make it work. There is so much tension going on in this book and I ate it right up. I also really loved all of the food descriptions as well as the music descriptions. I feel like this book really went for it with these characters' interests and lives apart from the romance. So by the end of the book, I was really rooting for the characters as individuals and as a couple. I loved the island vibes we had going on throughout the entire story. I just feel like this is a really good place to start if you are looking for a fun summertime read. Next, I'm so excited to recommend Shipped by Angie Hockman to you guys. This was just such a solid 5-star book for me. You have probably heard it pitched as being The Hating Game meets The Unhoneymooners, but for me, this book is just its own thing. The story follows these two co-workers who don't get along. Again, it's another enemies to lovers trope. And they work for this cruise line company and they both work in marketing and then they are both up for the same promotion. But the kicker is that before either one of them can get the promotion, they both have to go on one of the cruises together to try to put together this sales package of how they want to market the cruise in the future. Of course, they get on the ship together and maybe not all is what it seemed. Maybe they don't hate each other as much as they thought that they did. And as much as I love the characters in this book and I like even the side characters, I thought everyone was super fun and like really easy to love. The star of the book is the open water that the cruise is on and the islands. Like they go to the Galapagos, we're learning about the wildlife, we're getting in the ocean and snorkeling around, learning how to swim. I could just see it in my mind. And then what really made the book so special to me is that in the acknowledgement pages, Angie Hockman actually talks about her passion for travel and ecotourism and how she wanted to be able to weave the beauty of nature itself into this rivals to lovers story. So besides being just super fun to read, I feel like there was a really powerful message at the center of the story and I think you should be reading it this summer. The next recommendation is probably the most emotional book on this list, so just be aware, I'm gonna give you a few trigger warnings in a second here. It's Float Plan by Trish Dollar. When I say that I love this book and it just touched every nerve ending that my body has, this book made me cry, this book made me so emotional, and yes, a lot about this book was sad, but ultimately I feel like it is a feel-good read, I feel like it is uplifting. I have a new little book crush going on here, but we do have just an emotional trigger warning for suicide. At the beginning of this book, we learn that our main character, Anna, is trying to cope with the recent suicide of her fiancé. Together they had these sailing plans that they were going to go on together, so Anna decides that she wants to go on this trip by herself. But soon after she sets sail, she realizes she's bitten off more than she can chew, and actually it is very dangerous for her to be trying to sail by herself. So she kind of inadvertently recruits this professional sailor named Keen to come help her out and basically travel with her. Keen knows about loss himself. I don't know if you can see on the front of the book there, but he actually lost his leg earlier in his life, and then from there, the two just strike up this really beautiful friendship that just blossoms into something more. Highly recommend Float Plan if it sounds like something that you would enjoy. Next is a super, super, super quick recommendation. It's called The Date Swap, and I read this book on Scribd as an ebook, and I actually am not sure if it is only available to Scribd subscribers. It is so short. It's a fun little wedding story about these two people both traveling to Hawaii for these destination weddings within their families, and they are both single people and they both decide to like fake date for a little weekend and be each other's dates. It was very wholesome. It was nothing groundbreaking. Like, if this is only available on Scribd, I am not telling you to get Scribd just to read this book, but if you do have the service, I thought The Date Swap was just a really sweet read. Next, I'm gonna mention A Princess in Theory by Alyssa Cole, and like, even though this book doesn't, I don't know if it takes place in the summer or not, but like, there's nothing inherently summery about this book. It is one of the only mass market paperbacks that I've read in recent years that I absolutely tore through. And in my mind, that signals take this to the pool, you know? This is like a Cinderella slash Prince and the Pauper retelling. It's about this woman named Naledi, and she works so hard. She has multiple jobs. She's very intelligent, but right now she's just down on her luck, and she keeps getting these emails that this African prince wants to marry her and that like they have this arranged marriage situation going on, and she thinks it's spam, but it's actually not. So then on the other side of the story, there is this African prince who believes that he is to be betrothed to Naledi. So he travels from Africa to go meet her, and once he does, she mistakes him for like a new busboy at the restaurant where she works part-time, and instead of correcting her, he kind of just goes along with it, but then things get out of control really fast, and as the two begin to fall for each other, he doesn't know when is the right time to break the news to her that he is actually a prince. Without spoiling anything for you guys too, in the second half of the book, we actually do get to go to Africa, and there was just something so indulgent and elegant about the way that the African royal ceremonies and events were described. It's really screaming summer to me, even though this honestly could have taken place in any season. Let's also quickly hit on Second First Impressions by Sally Thorne. This one is mainly on the list because it is a new 2021 romance release. It's the latest Sally Thorne. It's a story that takes place within an elderly living community, even though the romance going on here is between two young people, like between 25, 30 years old. These two right here are temporary co-workers who don't really get off on the right foot, but quickly kind of adjust that and become friends. And then the other reason this comes to mind as a summer recommendation because of the turtles. So in this community where they live, there are just these turtles like roaming around on the sidewalks, and I just have some really fun images in my mind of these two going on walks together and looking out at the turtles just walking around, and it just seems like something I would want to be doing and reading about in the warm weather. Next, let's talk about The Honey Don't List by Christina Lauren. So last time I recommended this book, you guys act like I had slapped your grandma. So instead of shying away from talking about this book ever again, I'm actually just gonna double down and embrace how much I enjoyed The Honey Don't List. I don't know why people are so harsh. I thought this was so fun. This is another co-workers to lovers story. So picture a Chip and Joanna Gaines from Fixer Upper situation, like the couple in that TV show. That is kind of the setup for this book. It's a couple who runs a home renovation lifestyle brand slash company. They do shows, they actually do renovate people's homes, or at least design them. And from the outside looking in, these two have the perfect relationship, but each of their personal assistants knows the truth, and that is that this couple actually can't stand each other. So you can see where things are going just from page one, that obviously these two assistants are gonna end up having feelings for each other, and they're gonna struggle with whether or not to tell the world that everything is not what it seems between the two famous couple people. And just in case you're thinking, why is this on your summer list? There is a scene that goes down in a pool. It is a hotel pool, but it's a pool nonetheless, that I thought was really fun, and it is just burned in my memory. Next, let's talk about one to watch because I finally finished it, literally just so I could put it on this list. This book is about a plus-size beauty blogger and a social media sensation who goes on this fictionalized world's version of The Bachelorette. So she is The Bachelorette. I forget what they call it in this book. The main squeeze. She is the main squeeze. I used to be a huge fan of the entire Bachelor franchise. Now I just don't know what to think anymore. It's always been trash TV to me, but like here recently, I just don't know if I can continue doing it to myself. I've been such a supporter for so long. With that being said, I have watched the first two episodes of Katie's season that's going on right now. So if you enjoy that whole franchise, I feel like this would be a very timely recommendation to take me up on if you like watching Bachelorette. I also want to recommend The Right Swipe by Alicia Rye, and I'm looking at it sitting on my bookshelf right now, and I just cannot bring myself to get up and get it. This book is all about dating apps and how these two people who are the faces of two different dating apps end up falling in love, but it's more complicated than it seems. The beginning of the book talks about these two meeting out on a beach and having this fun little rendezvous together before everything kind of blows up in their faces. This is another one that isn't just solely one of those fun, really readable beach reads. I feel like there are a lot of important topics addressed in this book, but I really liked the layered themes going on. I felt like there was more meat to this story than just, oh, two people met on a dating app and then they didn't get along, and they did. And you know, like, I really enjoyed how much we had going on here, but I still thought it was simple to read. So this is a recommendation for you if you want that fun beach read type of book, but at the same time, you want like a little more substance. And the last summer recommendation that I have of the books that I actually have read is Fix Her Up by Tessa Bailey. And I never thought I would be recommending this book, but I actually look back on the reading experience very fondly, and I think that it is just a really compulsively page-turning romance. It's about this woman named Georgie who, when she was younger, she was obsessed with one of her older brother's friends, and he went on to be a professional baseball player, but now he has moved back to town, and like, the two end up getting together, which in general just is not a trope that I really look for or that I typically enjoy, but this one did have some fun scenes of them just going out to a little summery dinner and walking down the dock of a marina together. There was just a lot of heat in general going on in this book, and I actually have continued with the series quite recently, so let's go ahead and transition into section number two, which, as a reminder, these are going to be the books that I'm kind of in the middle of right now, so from here on out for the rest of the video, I'm not going to give quite as in-depth recommendations because I've not finished these books yet. So, like I said, I'm currently reading Love Her or Lose Her, which is the second book in this little trilogy. You don't have to read these books in order, but I am. I like doing that. This is a second chance romance about this married couple. They still have really great chemistry together, but they just haven't actually talked to each other in a while, so they're just trying to like go through everything. I feel like I'm making it sound very boring, but it's not. This is actually a very funny book. I'm also currently reading Play in the Palace by Paul Rudnick. This is an own voices male-male romance that seems like it would be kind of like a Red, White, and Royal Blue ripoff, and I'm not gonna say it's not, but this one did feel very different to me. I hate to continue the comparison, but this one is not as sophisticated as Red, White, and Royal Blue was, and there are far less like politics going on in this book. So for everyone who says like, oh, I really liked Red, White, and Royal Blue, but the politics was too much for me, this one is just so easy to read. But with me saying that, don't come back and be like, that book was dumb, or that book didn't have any substance, or you know what I mean? Like, obviously, this one is just much easier to read. It's very page-turning, and it's very fun. I'm also currently reading She's Faking It by Kristen Rockaway. It's about this woman who lives in a surf community called Pacific Beach, and it's in San Diego, and her life is just not going the way that she planned for it to go. She's a driver for a food delivery service, and she's just not happy. She has a lot of regrets. But she starts this Instagram account that kind of goes viral, and it just changes what she thinks the trajectory of her life is going to be. We have a little surfer guy, love interest here. I've really not read many love interests in that demographic, but look at this cover. She's in a coconut. It just doesn't get more summery than that. I'm also currently reading One Last Stop by Casey McQuiston. I have the audiobook for this. I'm sure everyone already knows what this book is, so I'll keep it short. It's a female-female romance that also features a time travel problem. I'm not super far into this because I don't have the audiobook sped up super fast because I'm just trying to take it all in and savor it while I can. I really am a fan of Casey McQuiston's writing style, and quite frankly, I'm really enjoying her take on magical realism. I'm having a blast. Lastly, for what I'm currently reading, might be my favorite of all of my current reads. It's Twice Shy by Sarah Hogle. This is an incredibly short book, less than 300 pages. This is about two people who have inherited the same house, and they're trying to like clean it out and decide who is gonna get what they're gonna do with the house. Why have they both inherited this house to begin with? They're not related. They are love interests, but I am currently still in the part of the book where they're just straight up not getting along. There's something about Sarah Hogle's writing style that just makes me laugh out loud. I did it with You Deserve Each Other. This was one of my highest anticipated releases for 2021, and I'm just kicking myself that I've not finished it yet because I'm really enjoying every single page. All right, you made it to the end of the video. I'm just gonna blast five books at you just really quickly that I'm looking forward to reading this summer. The first one is called It Happened One Summer, and this is by Tessa Bailey. We were just talking about her. This comes out on July 13th, which I feel like is a very interesting choice because the cover is screaming 4th of July to me. All I know is that it's a Schitt's Creek inspired rom-com. Schitt's Creek is one of my very favorite TV shows. It's like about this family that loses all of their money. They were very wealthy. Now they're not, and they have to move out to the middle of nowhere and live in a very, I don't want to say poor community, but just a community that that is not living up to their standards. So anything in that vein, I'm gonna think it's hilarious. I also am really looking forward to finally reading Anna Kay. This is a YA contemporary romance, and it is an Anna Karenina retelling. Anna Karenina is probably my favorite classic of all time, so I'm so excited to get to this retelling. I don't read retellings often, and this one just looks so bright and beautiful. I don't know what this book is about specifically, but if it is a true retelling, it's gonna be super juicy and dramatic, and I just can't ask for anything more of a summer read. I also really want to read It's Been a Pleasure, Nani Blake. This is gonna be one of those books that's actually about a woman finding herself, and I think she's trying to find herself like through her romance and her sexuality along the way. I think there is bisexual representation in this book. These types of books can be a hit or a miss for me. I feel like when I recently read Honey Girl, it was very middle of the road. We've got a romance going on, and we also have this coming of self type story, so I'll be really interested to see how Nani Blake rides that fine line. I also am looking to read Sorry Not Sorry. I have started this, but I've not gotten far enough into it to really consider myself having started it. This is about a woman who always plays by the rules until she starts listening to this podcast that makes her question everything and makes her start thinking, maybe I should be a little more bad. Maybe I should start taking some risks. We have a woman sitting in a margarita glass. I want that to be me so bad this weekend. And then lastly, I finally want to read Riley Thorne and The Dead Guy Next Door. This is another one that I own, and I'm looking at it right now and I just can't get up. This is about a woman who can communicate with dead people. I think she is clairvoyant, and also there is a murder mystery in the middle of the story. I think that she, Riley Thorne, I think that she has a blossoming romance with a detective on the case. There's supposed to be a lot of hijinks in this book. We're supposed to have some really good banter, and this is part of the Kindle Unlimited program that I have just joined. So I'm really looking forward to sitting down and reading it on my Kindle because the book seems really long. Every time I crack it open and try to start it, I get intimidated by the length. But reading it on my Kindle should work out for me. Thank you guys so much for sticking with me this long. Don't forget to click the link in my description box to visit the Ana Luisa website and use my discount code CarolineJohnson10 to get 10% off of your entire order from Ana Luisa. Thank you guys so much for the love, for the support. I hope you enjoy all of these book recommendations. I will see you in the next video. Bye.